This is one I have to admit that I missed when it originally aired. Well, mostly. I do recall catching an episode or two, but 1999 was a busy year for me and I could never catch it from the beginning, whereas many of my friends might have said they were too old for cartoons at the time. Well, ones that weren't Family Guy or anime, I was still trying to keep track of the good ones. It's just hard for a teenager to wake up early on a Saturday, and to be honest, the title turned me off. This is The Big Guy and Rusty the Boy Robot, a show I should have given a real chance. Airing on Fox Kids from 1999 to 2001, this was a collaborative effort from Columbia TriStar and Dark Horse Entertainment. It was based off of a comic by Frank Miller and Jeff Darrow, but from what I've seen, the show has several differences to its source material. Big Guy and Rusty follows the two titular characters on a number of adventures as they defend Earth from a slew of different enemies, with their main antagonists being a group of evil robotic scientists known as the Legion Ex Machina. The dynamic comes, of course, with Rusty the Boy Robot being just that, a young kid, but one with a lot of firepower and no pain receptors. The Big Guy is a giant metal husk with cache of weapons in his elbows and wrists that is piloted by Lieutenant Dwayne Hunter. But that's a secret, even to Rusty. Only a few people are aware that there is a human component to their savior, as the Army originally promised a fully functioning AI-powered champion. Some of the adventures the two go on are crazy, battling everything from other robots, monsters, and aliens to fighting in space and alternate timelines. Just as a clue for what this world is like, Hunter seems unfazed by all of this and still manages to have some clever quips prepared for any situation. Also, they never explain the talking monkey thing, but there is a great joke about it in the end.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Jenny, do something!
Like what? Spit on him?
What? Bobo, did you hear that? Another like myself.
Keep him talking.
You think you're the only game in town, handsome?
But how could this be? Your origin. You must tell.
Finally, someone who cares. It all started when, as a small monkey, I found myself...
Double chin clock job.
Oh well, some other time.
The episodes do go together, where their events affect the characters and future plot points, forming an ongoing story with recurring villains. There's even a to-be-continued at one point with a nice cliffhanger. Most of the plots are predictable to anyone who knows any basic science fiction, but it's a great education in classic storytelling for kids. The show has some adult moments and ideas. Not only do they keep lying to Rusty, but there is gunfire, something I point out since showing realistic bullets in cartoons had become hard to get past quality assurance at that point, or where he literally uses Rusty as a weapon after taking his feet off and attaching the boy robot to his severed arm and firing him. The kid even tries to sacrifice himself to save the others at one point. I just like that they weren't pulling the punches around every corner. Rusty does make a shit joke at one point that I admittedly chuckled at, and he says darn in other words close to cursing.
Whoa, number two just hit the fan.
The show is mostly just monsters and robots dying, but it still comes across as brutal, and some of the creations from Darrow are a tad gross at times. Big Guy and Rusty is kind of inspirational for kids though. There are some moral lessons that aren't too in your face, and it shows that everyone can be helpful and have their moment to shine. I like that Rusty learns by watching others, figuring out how to handle difficult situations with a child's mentality. He has a mother and son relationship with Dr. Slate, who learns how to talk to him as a superpowered child, but still trust him in some moments. There is the whole sidekick theme, of course, but also those of new versus old and the positive and negative effects of technology. There is some great writing with the show, especially in the witty dialogue and weird quotes.
President, I just wanted to say hello.
Hello?
Who are you?
Rusty the Robot. You want the president? You deal with me. What? What's so funny?
You're cute, kid, but you're no match for Big Rick.
Big who?
scram, Pee-wee. This is between the big boys now.
Pee-wee? I'll have you know I am a walking nucleoprotonic arsenal, which...
For the love of the mic.
Dumb robot.
Actually, I'm neither.
Fact, the only thing more piping hot than Mom's fresh baked apple pie is the sting of my anti-low-life terrorist mag popper. Want a slice? Smart fella.
The humor is overall good, but goes a little too silly at times, which I knew was coming. Honestly, it seems more grounded in its own world than I expected it to be. A few clever references as well, with the obvious Batman and Robin comments.
Oh, please, Dr. Slate! Robin gets to hang out at the Batcave.
Batman and Robin are cartoon characters, Rusty. You're real.
And some fun Star Wars bits that fit excellently.
Guys, listen up. It's me, Rusty Senior.
I am your father.
The show overall is way more self-aware than some it would be compared to at first glance, and doesn't hinder itself by trying to go too far in one direction or the other. The element that kept holding me the most was the voice acting. I immediately recognized so many of the voices and attached to them. Rusty and Joe are voiced by Pamela Adlon, and she has a perfect pitch for the boy robot, along with being one of my favorite characters from Californication, Marcy, but most know her as Bobby from King of the Hill. Lieutenant Hunter is performed by Jim Hanks, who does voice work for his brother Tom. Steven Root is also fantastic in this as the douche Dr. Donovan and his comedic timing from things like News Radio and Office Space Show. But like his co-star, he's also from King of the Hill as neighbor Bill.
You have been kicked in the testicles. Oh, I wish I had a son to kick me in the nuts.
Be careful what you wish for.
There are many more, though, like Kathy Kinney as Jenny the Monkey, R. Lee Ermey as General Thornton, and Kevin Michael Richardson as Garth. Not to mention the numerous guest stars who make excellent villains like Tim Curry and Clancy Brown. Each of these people brought their characters to life, and so many of them could have used more screen time. I hate that I didn't make time for this show when it originally ran. I think they handled it well and took the property past where the comics had, having more time to breathe and grow. The show ran for 2 seasons, with the first only having 6 episodes and the second containing 20. For everyone wondering, my favorite one is where they go into the internet. The show can be purchased on DVD through Amazon for hardcore fans. I'm not sure this is one I would want to watch through a bunch, but for the love of Mike, I do recommend checking it out in some form, at least to hear that catchy theme song, if nothing else.
Watch the sky. Born of a rose.